lesson incorporates passages from both the Old Testament and the New Testament. From the prophecy of Isaiah, chapter number 40, these words can be found in verses 1 and 2, 29 through 31. Comfort ye my people, saith your God. Speak ye comfortably to Jerusalem, and cry unto her that her warfare is accomplished, that her iniquity is pardoned, for she hath received of the Lord's hand double for all her sins. He giveth power to the faint, and to them that have no might, he increaseth strength. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. Amen. And then from the New Testament division of God's Holy Word, specifically from Paul's initial epistle to the Corinthian congregation, chapter number 8, verse number 4, and verses 9 to 13. As concerning therefore the eating of those things that are offered in sacrifice unto idols, we know that an idol is nothing in the world, and that there is none other God but one. But take heed, lest by any means this liberty of yours become a stumbling block to them that are weak. For if any man see thee which has knowledge sit at meat in the idol's temple, shall not the conscience of him which is weak be emboldened to eat those things which are offered to idols? And through thy knowledge shall the weak brother perish for whom Christ died? But when ye sin so against the brethren and wound their weak conscience, ye sin against Christ. Wherefore, if meat make my brother to offend, I will eat no flesh while the world standeth, lest I make my brother to offend. God bless the reading. God bless the hearing of his most precious, precious word.
Thank you. to this great man of God, Dr. Michael Neely Harris, to this great congregation, members and friends. It is indeed an honor and a privilege to be found here at the Wheat Street Church. I too was very humbled when Sister Catherine Hines called me to make an official invitation from Dr. Harris. Oh, Saints of God, it is with remission that I say to you today that most people who attend church do not fully understand real worship. Most people who are on the active rolls of churches, even in the year of our Lord 2014, think that it is the choir's responsibility to worship. Most think it's the praise team's responsibility to worship. Most think, well, it's the leaders of the church's responsibility to worship. But beloved, I've come by here to let you know that if the Lord has done anything for you, if the Lord has ever brought you through any storm, any valley, if the Lord has ever delivered you from any infirmity, if the Lord has ever strengthened you in any moment of weakness, that is your opportunity. that God still has his mind on your dreams.
All right.
That God has not forgotten about you.
Uh-huh.
And beloved, I just need you to hear me say that Isaiah didn't just stop with this initial word of comfort to those that were uncomfortable. But he went on to say that God was going to give those who To my visionaries in the house. To those who are yet waiting on the promises of God. To those that your anthem is, I will trust in the Lord. And I promise him that I'm going to serve him until I die. If that's your kind of anthem, I need you to stand with me today. Just the dreamers, just the dreamers. Come on, if you're not a visionary, you're not going to receive what I'm doing. This ain't for you. I don't mean to leave you out. I'm going to bring you in, but this moment ain't for you. But to those who are visionary enough, you still believe that we serve a miracle working God. Get your miracle on your mind right now. I got to go now. Get your miracle on your mind. Get your impossibility on your mind. Get it on your mind. Somebody needs to get some deliverance on their mind. Come on, come on, come on. Somebody in here has more bills than they have finances. Come on, you need to get it on your mind. Come on, come on. I heard in my Sunday school class that somebody has some friends that they need to be praying for right now because their friends are lost on the restless sea of time. Come on, get your friends on your mind right now. Come on, right now, right now, right now. Those of you who know that God is still able, I need you to get it on your mind right now. And for somebody under the sound of my voice, somebody here under the sound of my voice, and you got Wheat Street on your mind. Come on, you want God to do a work, a wonder work in the Wheat Street church community. Come on, get it on your mind. Get it on your mind. And you're not being selfish. I'm gonna prove it to you. I'm gonna prove it to you. Because God will make you a blessing so that you can bless somebody else. You're not being selfish. If you really are a dreamer, get it on your mind. Get it on your mind. Now what I want you to do, those who can do two things at one time, I want you to pray for those that are not standing right now. Pray that God would right now at this moment give them a vision, give them something to hope for. Come on, come on, pray with me now. I'm in your Sunday school lesson. I'm right in 1 Corinthians chapter number 8. Come on, pray for those that may not be on your level right now. That God would stir up the gift in them, that they might join with us to bring others to a saving relationship with God. Beloved, I came right here to tell you as we go to the invitation to Christian discipleship, that God still has your dream on his mind. God still has the vision that he gave you in the hollow of his hand. God still has your blessing. And he's waiting for the right moment to give it to you. Hold on to your dream. Don't ever let it go. And God said that college degree is yours if you ask. And God says that healing is yours if you ask. And God says that deliverance is yours if you ask. And God said that next level of ministry is yours if you ask. And your family can live in peace. I receive that. Because more than one person is asking for peace in their family. So God said to Bernie, pronounce it again, that you can have peace in your house. You don't have to come to church just to get some peace. If he's the Prince of Peace at church, he ought to be the Prince of Peace where you live, where you work, where you shop. He's the Prince of Peace. Let him speak peace to you today. Now to the rest of us who are in this house, if you are able to stand with me today, this is the invitation to Christian discipleship. Whatever your malady, whatever your infirmity, God can deliver you from that.
Whatever your circumstance, whatever your situation, we serve a God who is not confined by situations. He is an almighty, all-powerful God. He is El Shaddai. Can somebody in the house say El Shaddai? He is El Shaddai. Come on, somebody say El Shaddai. That means that he is the almighty God. There is absolutely nothing he cannot do. Absolutely nothing that he cannot do. So if your desire today is salvation, no matter what your background is, no matter what your history is, no matter what yesterday used to be, God wants to deliver you to a brighter tomorrow. Is there one today under the sound of my voice that will accept the invitation for Jesus Christ to come into your life, into your heart? Is there a candidate for baptism today? Someone who will stretch out, call on the name of Christ, and allow Christ to be the Lord of their heart and their lives. Maybe there's someone here that it is your desire to join yourself with the Wheat Street Church, and we give that invitation today that you will become a part of this ministry. Is there one today that desires to come forward and acknowledge that they want to be a part of this church fellowship? Let the church say amen. Yes. I got to let the Lord do his business. Yes.
Thank you.
taking time out of your busy schedule to hear us as we call on you. We thank you for what transpired here this day, for using this preacher as you used him this day. And Lord, we thank you for just allowing us to have this opportunity to worship you in spirit and in truth. We thank you for the candidates for baptism who came during the course of our vacation Bible school and are seated even now on the first pew. But we recognize, God, that there may be others who believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, who are ready to give to him their lives. And we pray that they too will join those who came during the course of the week and surrender to him. We recognize that even though this preacher extended your invitation, that there may be others who now realize that the invitation is for them. And they may feel inclined even now to say, as old folks used to say, I yield, I yield. Can't hold out any longer. And we pray that they will do so even now. Lord, there are persons who have come with concerns on their minds. And we pray, God, that you will do what only you can do in dealing with those concerns that they have. They may have concerns about their own lives, concerns about somebody else. You know what it is. You know who it is. So, Lord, we just lay our all on the altar and turn matters into your hands. But be with whomever. Let him or her know that you're God all by yourself. Too good to ever be bad, too wise to ever be wrong. Lord, somebody may need you in terms of making a major decision. Somebody may need you in terms of forgiveness, because maybe he or she may have done that which was contrary to your will. You are a forgiving God, and we thank you for that, because all of us have needed your forgiveness for something, and you have done just that. Somebody may be here, Lord, just to simply say thank you. Thank you for what you have done. Thank you for what you are doing. Thank you for what you will do. And so, Lord, we all thank you. We may thank you for different things, but you deserve our thanks. And as has been said, you are worthy to be praised, because you're a good God. You're a great God. You're a gracious God. You're a redeeming God. You're a righteous God. You're an on-time God. Yes, Lord, we have so much to thank you for. And we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Lord, there's so many other things that we can lift in prayer even now. But you know. You know them better than we know them ourselves. And so, Lord, just take charge. Have thine own way. Have thine own way. Thou art the potter. We are but the pieces of clay. Mold us and make us after your will. While we are waiting, Lord, yielded and still. Be with us now. Be with us always, we pray. offer this prayer in the precious name of Jesus Christ, our leader, our teacher, our redeemer, our